Hi, welcome to Nightmare Camp, The Asylum 2. I'm Landros, and for those of you who are new to my channel and new to any of the series that I've done, this is basically a sequel to the original Asylum Challenge that I did. For those of you who have been with me for a while, I'm going to tell you right now, this is going to be very different from the original one that we did. But for all of you, thank you for actually giving this a chance and stopping by. Please, I hope you will stick around, subscribe, and continue to be with me through this entire thing. It's not a very long-term challenge. As you know, the original one didn't last that long. I don't think this one's going to last that long either, but it's going to be a lot of fun. Now, you'll notice we're in a different town. We're actually going to be doing this challenge in Hidden Springs, and I have not done a whole lot of editing. I'm not actually going to because we don't interact that much with the town. So, for the most part, we're going to leave it unaltered. The only thing we're going to do is we're going to create the actual asylum, and it's going to be way over here on the edge of town, over on this huge 64 by 64 lot. So what I need to do is go ahead and stop for a moment, get the lot ready, and then I'll be back in just a moment to kind of show you what I've done, and then we'll get our cast of characters ready to go. Be back in just a second. All right, well, here we are, and I'm going to go ahead and go into Build By real quick so we can take a look at it a little bit closer. You can actually choose whatever you want. You can use any kind of lot you want. You have no restrictions in this as far as what you build and what you buy, as far as money that you spend. Use the motherlode cheat, do whatever you can do to get the people into it. But this is basically the remnants of an old summer camp that the only part that's actually remaining is this part right here, and they have converted it into an outpatient facility for asylum inmates. Now, of course, I got the little water fountain there. That's why it's got the little bubble over it. But anyway, I'm gonna show it to you in a lot more detail. But as you can see, whoa, we got this big mountain behind us. That's what it kind of makes it a little bit difficult. That's why I was really not sure I wanted to do it on this lot, but it's the only one that actually fit. All right, so let me go ahead and just drop down here. The entranceway will take us up to the main building, and I'm going to show you that in just a minute. But our first stop is going to be over here at one of the outhouse buildings, which is actually, or not outhouse, one of the cabins. And as I roll it back down, you'll actually get an idea of what we're dealing with on the inside. Now, this is a lot that I created specifically for this challenge, so I'm not the greatest of builders, but I can have some, if I take some time, I can do something that's somewhat passable, but this is okay. All right, we've got two beds, and remember, you can only have a certain amount of beds. We're going to have 8 characters, and there can only be 5 sleepable pieces of furniture. These are 2 of them, and of course, we've got our hamper here for the dirty clothes, but inside, they have a jelly bean bush, and you got to be careful because that thing can kill you, and you're going to see them all throughout the entire area. Over here on this side, it's just more decorative items right here, so we've got the little water tower, got the carts and everything back here by the side, but it was just kind of a decorative area for the lot. And then I gave them a little area here so that they could actually come out and play around with the sprinkler. So, you know, they're going to get bored. They need something to do. Okay. Gave them the nub set, which is just one fun activity that they can use. And of course, I gave them the sign so they know which way to go when they want to head to the bathroom or wherever they want to go. The other room over here for the others, I don't know if it's going to be the girls or the guys. It's going to be basically whoever gets to it first. It has the other 3 remaining beds that we can use along with their jelly bean bush. Back here in the back, it's all, again, more decorative. It's just kind of like the remnants of the old camp. Some things have been here. Some things were gone. It's the farmers that were here, and they actually have left a lot of stuff. So you can kind of see where they've just kind of turned this into a catch-all for whatever the town needed. Okay, the inside of the main building, let me go ahead and roll that back up to you. I thought it fit in with the theme of the town pretty well. It's this log cabin feel. And of course, we've got these megaphones out here in the front because I figured each inmate would need to have one just so that they could actually be mean and cruel and they could actually shout at people. And I thought it might be kind of fun. All right, going inside, we have a dartboard for fun. I gave them 1 television because remember, you can have a TV or you can have a computer. Last asylum, I did the computer. This one, we're going to do the TV. Got our fireplace here. There is only 1 bookcase. I could not deal with another round of all those books, so 1 bookcase and that's it. The first of the 5 skill building items would be the guitar. The second one, of course, is the piano. We do have a couple of jelly bean bushes here, and then there's a couple more over here on this side as well. The third skill building item is a actual slot machine from the casino because it does build the gambling skill. The only restriction on this is that my sim that I can control cannot use it. Everybody else can use it. He can't. So they'll use it autonomously, and that's why I picked things that they would use. And yeah, it's going to help us with money, but then again, there's no guarantee that they're going to use it, and who knows what they'll do. Okay, we got our washer and dryer. We got everything else we needed. Remember that you cannot have any fire alarm. You cannot have any burglar alarm, so you're stuck. And if the burglar comes and takes those things, we're kind of sunk. But, you know, it can happen. All right, the 4th of the skill building items will be found out here on the back porch, and that is our telescope. next to our Party Maximus statue. And we have a juice kegger for fun as well. And you can see right there in the background what our fifth skill building item is. It is the basketball court. And I went ahead and put that out there because it's one of my favorite items. I debated on this or the soccer goal, and I went with the basketball at the end. Gave them the swing so they have something else to come out here and do. Over here on the other side, I did give them a bonfire pit so that they can come out here and they can have fun. They also have this treehouse so that if any of them actually decide to build their relationship up and they want to go woohoo, they got another place to go. Okay, over here, they can sleep in it, can't they? No, I don't think they can. I think only the kids can sleep in it. So I don't think so. If the adults look like they can sleep in it, I'll delete it. Or either I'll delete a bed. I'll just take a bed out. So I think only the kids can sleep in it. This back here is just more decorative. And of course I put Sasquatch back there. It had to. So Bigfoot's there. Here's the danger part of our asylum. This is what makes it a nightmare. To get to the one and only set of bathrooms, you got to walk down an entire row of flesh-eating cow plants. And there's 8 of them. One to represent each of the different inmates here in the asylum. Now the rule that I'm putting on this is that if any of them die due to neglect, we have to automatically replace it regardless. So you always have to have at least 8 of these cow plants living at any given moment. So if any of them happen to die because of neglect, we do have to come out here and we have to replace them. All right, we do have one shower, we do have one bathroom, and there's only one sink. Remember, you can only have that one. There is a jelly bean bush here in both areas, so in case somebody gets hungry and they don't want to make it all the way to the actual kitchen, they have an alternative. I don't think it would be the best one, but that's what we're dealing with. Now, in the original asylum challenge, I didn't know if it was one sink for the bathroom and the kitchen combined. I believe it is supposed to be one for each. So I'm just doing it as, you know, there's a sink here in the kitchen. There is a sink out there. If it's wrong, okay, remember, I'm deviating somewhat from this challenge. Okay, so that's the main thing. All right, that is basically our asylum. That is what we are working with. A lot of places out here so that they want to come out here and do something. I don't have any kind of footballs or anything like that. I wish I did, but of course they can't. But they could actually come out and they could play. They could do the water fight and whatnot because I've got enough room. And when it snows, they could do snowball fighting if they wanted to. All right, that is our asylum. Let me go ahead and roll this back up to show you what it looks like. And of course, I'm going to show it to you at night as well, because I always like to show you two different alternatives. And you can't really tell much because this thing right here is driving me nuts. But anyway, that is our asylum. It's got a nice backdrop of the mountains and everything. Again, I thought it fit the town very well. It's on the outskirts, so nobody's going to know what's going to go on back here. Oh, there's another woohoo spot right here in case they really get relationships high. So don't know that that's going to happen. All right, so basically that takes care of our asylum. I'm ready to go ahead and get our characters created. So if you'll just give me a moment, I'm going to go ahead and drop back into our game setup, and we are going to get these guys ready to go and get them moved in. I'll be back in just a moment when I have them all ready to go. All right, so here we go. The first of our Sims that we're going to actually look at is Nicholas Truman, and Nicholas is actually the character that I'm going to be following through the entire LP. Now, Nicholas has a lifetime wish to be the world-renowned surgeon, so he'll go into the medical career. His traits are excitable, friendly, and then the ones that you must choose are insane, loser, and neurotic. I believe neurotic. I think so. Okay, anyway, they all are neurotic, so that's what I gave them. Anyway, that is Nicholas. That's who we are actually going to use as our lead character. Now, his first housemate is Ariel Adams, and you'll see where I got my inspiration by the names and by what they're dressed as. Okay, she's going in the science career to be a creature robot crossbreeder. Remember, these are all random. You have to just choose whatever comes up whenever you do I did random.org. Anyway, she is absent-minded, childish, she's insane, neurotic, and over-emotional. You're going to notice that I took away the trait hates the outdoors, and there's a reason for that. Okay, so the next actual Sim joining us is Darius Fry. Now, Darius, he's got an interesting look here, but anyway, he wants to be the master thief, so he'll go into the criminal career. He's absent-minded, he is childish, he's insane, kleptomaniac, and neurotic. Okay, the next person is, of course, Jeannie Farrington. And Jeannie has her personality traits. First of all, she wants to be the CEO of a mega corporation. She is absent-minded, ambitious, flirty, insane, and neurotic. Okay, the next one is Jefferson Brandt, and Jefferson would be our Prince Charming, I guess, of the group. Jefferson wants to actually be the leader of the free world. He is absent-minded, charismatic, he's insane, mamooch, and neurotic. Now, what would a prince be without a princess in training? And that would be our next character. And this is a Megan Pruitt. And Megan is going to also go into the science career. She is also absent-minded. She's easily impressed, hopeless romantic, insane, and neurotic. A prince and princess are nothing without an evil queen. And the evil queen will be Eliza Huggins. And Eliza's personality, she is going to be swimming in cash for her lifetime reward. She would like to be, or she's absent-minded, she's insane, neurotic, she's got no sense of humor, and a snob. I debated on making her evil. I decided at the last minute not to. It just kind of goes, it's implied. The final character in our entire cast here is actually a returning character from the original Asylum, the only one, and of course, Deshaun Leyva. You cannot have an asylum without good old Deshaun. So I brought him back. And, of course, Deshaun is also going to be in the criminal career. He's trying to be the Emperor of Evil. He actually is absent-minded. He is evil. He's insane, mean-spirited, and rebellious. So there you have it. Those are the eight. Let's go ahead and lock them in. And what I'm going to do is make sure there are no relationships that you need to set up because, of course, they're not supposed to have any. So once this actually registers and we got them all here in the portrait, I'm going to go ahead and lock them in. And yes, we're going to go ahead and continue. I'll be back in a moment when it's ready. They're ready to move into the house. All right, so here we are. Now, to get into this house is too expensive for us. We can't actually do it. So the way you're going to have to do it, you need to make sure your cheats are turned on. But you go ahead and type in free real estate. Once you do that, everything should become available to us, which this house is available. Furnished, this thing is going to cost us a little over $71,000, which is perfect. We're going to go ahead and purchase that as it is, and I'm going to go ahead and lock that in, and we're going to get moved in. Give me just a second, because it does take a little while to load them in there. All right, well, here we are. We are lined up. I'm on pause. I'm just doing this for just a moment. The change in my rules, as opposed to the original Asylum. In the original Asylum that I did, nobody was allowed to leave the lot, including my sim. In this one, everybody gets to leave. I'm going to have one thing that I'm going to be able to do. I'm going to be able to actually go ahead, click on each of them as they get their original lifetime wish desire or their career desire, and then I'm going to go ahead and set them up, get them their job. Once I do that, they're all on their own, and we're only going to work with Nicholas. So I do have to do that. This way, they have a risk of getting fired. They have a risk of, or they could actually do really well in their jobs. Who knows? But the only person I'm actually going to continue to control after I get them their initial jobs, of course, is Nicholas. But we're going to wait until everybody gets what they need. And it shouldn't take but just a second. And I've already actually gone through and done story progression. So we're just going to go ahead and, okay, we're going to go ahead and lock them in with whatever they want. And then once they have that, tell you what, let me go ahead and stop because I don't want them to do anything because I'm going to have them all leaving in just a moment. Okay, now some of them are going to go to the same places, which is fine. Let's go ahead and just start right off with Ariel. Ariel is wanting to go into the science career, and it's all the way on the other side of town, so good luck with her getting there on time. All right, let's go ahead and tell her to go get a job. She's going to join the science career. Her roommate right here, Megan, is also going to do that as well, and I'm going to let them go ahead. Now, Darius is going over to the Emperor of Evil, or actually one of the criminal careers, so he's going to be the Master Thief. He'll go ahead and join that career, and I'm going to have, where's the next person, which is us. Nicholas is going to go over to the hospital, which is not there. It's not there. It's right here in front of me. So we're going to go join the medical career. Jeannie, you want to be in business. Now, the business center is right here, so we're going to go ahead and have her join that career. Deshaun, I know you wanted to go watch TV, but you can't do that. You got to go get your job first. And I got to hurry before, now she wanted to be in business. All right. Since she really didn't have a specific career, business it is. And our little Prince Charming here wants to go to City Hall. He's going to be the political guy. All right. So I got them all taken care of. I'm going with Nicholas because he's the only one at this point that I can control. I will get the option to accept their jobs in just a moment, which I will do. After that, everybody's on their own to find their way back home. And of course, you know, you don't have to stay on the lot. You do have to stay on the lot, we do, after work. So unless we're actually working, we got to come back to the lot. Or if we bring everybody at the same time. So if we want to go to the festival, I got to make a group of it and bring everybody that's actually at the house at that moment, everybody that's off of work and can go, I got to take them all. Okay, go ahead and accept the career. And I figured that just gives us to where we're not all just completely stir crazy, because even they get stir crazy, even I do. So this way, but you got to make sure you can all go together. So on Thursdays on the festival, it's the only day that we can go do it. So that's why I'm saying it. But yeah, we can go together as a group if I actually lock him in as a group. All right, so he got his job. Looks like everybody is getting theirs for the most part. Let's see, we got four of them at least. Okay, here comes number five. All right, so Jeannie got her job. Megan got hers. And, of course, Deshaun, you know he's going to get his job. So everybody's got one. It's going to be interesting seeing if they can actually go to work and do what they got to do without me having to do any kind of interactions with them. I can't help them anyway. Can't do any of the dragons, can't do any of the massage tables, can't do any of that kind of fun stuff. We're just basically, you're very limited on what you can put into the asylum. And so what I've got in there, that's all you have. All right. Now, I believe that should be everybody except for Jefferson. I think he's the only one who's still waiting. All right, the mascot's here. Yeah, there we go. Go ahead and accept that career. I really don't care about the mascot, but that's all right. Now, the only other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and give everybody their megaphone because everybody's supposed to have one. That's the reason I lined up eight of them out here. So let me go ahead and pause them real quick, and I'm going to just, it's the only time I can do this is on that first day to get them set up. So let's go ahead and just line them up. Everybody gets one. Whether they use it or not, that's completely up to them. I don't really care. Yeah, it will help you with your social network or with your rebel influence, but it's not going to help you with any kind of skill. So I figure this is fine. We can do that. All right. And then, of course, we've got two more. And once they're done, they are done. It's going to be interesting with these cow plants because they gravitate toward them very quickly. All right. I'm going to go ahead and go back to Nicholas and see what he wants. He wants to learn logic, and he wants to read a book about logic. I don't know if we have one, but let's go out here and actually just do some stargazing real quick. And I'm going to look over here and see if we do happen to have a logic book. Wondering why we got two of these. Do we have two bookcases? Please tell me I don't have two bookcases. I think I might. Let me just double check. So, I mean, you can have as many bookcases as you want, but for some reason I'm getting double books. I shouldn't, but I did. It's okay because I don't have anything in the rooms. So apparently we're just getting it. He can go ahead and lock that in because we can read a book about it. And let's see, you want to go to the bookstore? You can go to the bookstore and you can go to the grocery store. Those are the only two outings you can do. So if I want to go there, I can do it. So we will do that eventually. And you want to talk about your job, maybe to somebody, that's fine. If somebody gets home. Okay, of course, you know, you get points based on how many skills they learn. I'm going to try to do my best to learn as many as I can with him. Oh, buddy, did you burn yourself or something? What happened? I have no idea. All right, so Eliza's already found something. She's dumpster diving over there, so you can see they're actually getting some fun. They're doing some stuff outside. I could click on them and I could look at them, but I can't really actually interact with them. This guy needs to go, or girl, whoever it is. Whoever that is fine. All right, so Madeline is actually going ahead. That's not ours. We don't have a Madeline. Too bad. It would have been nice to have a... Oh, look at you. You're going to come drinking at our place. That's all right. You go ahead and do exactly what you want to do because everybody else is going to do it too. All right, so I just want to get him at least that first logic skill point, and then I'm going to switch him over there and have him start reading that book. I'll work on whatever wishes he wants. I can't do the elixirs. I could buy one. I don't know how we would get one because, unfortunately, we can't go there. We can't go to that shop. I don't even think I have one in the town. Yeah, you're looking into the sun, buddy. You shouldn't be doing that. I guess it's a bad thing. But you're not getting a bad moodlet. I'm just hoping that you can finish this up pretty quickly, which isn't going to take much longer. Now, there's nobody else here. I'm wondering where they're all at. Again, they will find their way home. I can actually have him, once he actually gets this done, I want to actually switch him over to read a book. I'm going to have him read logic again, and he should be able to do that inside, so it's not going to be too bad. I was hoping he'd just use this for the first skill point, but he looks like he's getting close. He really is. I just don't want him to have anything bad happen to him outside. Let's see. Sebastian isn't ours. All right, so Jeannie's actually got a sofa for us, so she went dumpster diving. It's pretty cool. I can't use any of that stuff, but they can go out and grab it. I feel horrible, buddy. I really do. All right, so now that you got your first skill point, you go ahead. Now, I'm going to go ahead, and I'm going to just click over and see where they are. I can't actually look at their needs. You'll notice I'm still on Nicholas. So, all right, she's over here dumpster diving. Where's the dumpster? Okay, well, I guess you left it already. All right, let's go see where Megan is. Megan, you're actually already on the way home? Yeah, she's home. Okay, so she's finally making her way here. And that's okay. We got... Darius is back. I'm wondering who's, oh, he's already got the cow plant on the mind. But that's okay. Right now they're not hungry. Okay, looks like everybody's showing up back home, so I'm not going to worry about going and finding them. Our little queen over here is heading out. I don't know their names as well right off, but that's Eliza, and she's going off. Can't really do anything with her, but that's okay. Oh, look at you. Now, where's Deshaun? That's the one I'm wondering where he would be at. I'm sure some of you guys have probably sent gifts over here. You see that they're sparkling, but nobody knows that this is actually being recorded right now because I haven't told anybody that I'm recording it. That's okay. So you guys have no idea that it's actually being done. That's why I'm not going to go out there and check for gifts. But we will have to check for or pay the bills pretty soon. Oh, wait, that reminds me. Stop everything. We got to reduce our funds because I got a lot of money and I can't have that. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. It's going to be family funds, Truman, and it can only be $100. All right, so there we go. Scare me to death. I almost messed up. And they didn't buy anything, so it's okay. They didn't actually try to buy anything while we were there because I was looking at these pop-ups, seeing if their names showed up. So they're fine. We didn't actually lose anything. All right, all these things are my story progression and register mod that I actually are working on everything. Okay, so she got a tissue box. Well, Jeannie, you're making us getting us some stuff at least, and that's all going to come into kind of come in handy at the end when we actually have to tally up how much money and what our net worth is. Okay, I'm just kind of hoping that I knew they would gravitate towards this. And it's something that I was very conscious of when I actually was creating this lot. I wanted to avoid some of the mistakes that were made in the original asylum because it tended to be that they were stuck doing the same thing over and over. All they really wanted to do was read. You're going to notice I have dressed them all in some of the most unique and crazy items so that I could think of. So I gave them all different things for their sports, for their athletic, their formal, their sleepwear. It's all going to be different. And since they're insane, you never know what they're going to be wearing. It can be anything at any given time. So, all right. Looks like everybody's gravitating out there towards the cow plants, which I have no idea what they're going to do over here. But that's all right. At least our guy is getting something done. I'm going to just click over here so I can get closer to him. Yeah, they're fine. As long as they're feeding them, they're okay. It's only when you see the cake sticking out of their mouth when you have to worry. And right now, nobody's actually giving me any reason to worry. So I'm going to let him just continue doing exactly what they're doing. He's doing pretty well. I think he's actually working on his third skill point. So, no, he's working on his second. Ah, that stinks. But I want to just have him just continue this because as a doctor, he definitely needs that as a skill. The rest of them, they're on their own. If they don't want to do anything to build their skills, that's their choice. Now, before we actually go any further, okay, there's our little Prince Charming over here. So, Jefferson, you're over here. You're going to light the fire. Didn't even look at their ages. Nicholas is actually 19. You know what? That's one thing I'm going to stop and do. Because I do have the Master Controller mod in my game, I am going to set everybody down on an equal setting. I'm going to go ahead and make sure that I make everybody start off on the exact same age. So to do that, you just go into Master Controller. It's under, I believe it's Intermediate, and you go to Absolute Age, and you're going to just type in as a 0. So I figure everybody deserves to start off on the very same setting. So let's just go ahead and do that, and I'm hoping that this is actually working on hers. Yeah, as long as you click on them, you're fine. But this way, I don't have to worry about somebody aging up before us. It gives them all a fair shot. And you got to keep them alive all the way to the end until they get their lifetime career, or until we get ours, so not till they get theirs. Problem is, some of them are going to die. I'm going to tell you that right now. With these cow plants and these jelly bean bushes, I don't see a long life for many of them. We may end up by ourselves at the very end. And if that's the case, we may have to think about moving in new inmates. I don't know. So it's just one of those deals. All right, so I've gotten pretty much everybody here at the house. Let's see, who is this? I have no idea. Jeannie, let me get you set up. All right, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and finish this up. Let's see, I think there's not much more for me to actually do with these people. I know I'm still waiting on Deshaun. I have no idea where the guy is. Did I get everybody at home? I think I got everybody here except for her. Okay, and I do need to make sure I get her. I'm just still waiting on Deshaun. I have to go find him. He's already lost. Okay, let me go over and, yep, I got all these people. Deshaun, you're way over here, aren't you? You're still at the criminal place, and you're on the phone. You're plotting already. Okay, let's get you set up too. Master Controller, Intermediate, and get your age. I think I got everybody. I might have missed somebody. So before, I'm not going to check their needs. I'm going to keep it on this panel because I already know all of this stuff. I created it. I'm just going to check to make sure that everybody, yeah, Ariel, I got to go back and fix you. Everybody else should be okay. All right, so let me see. And I know, I'm just going to go back to Ariel real quick. Oh, yeah, she wasn't on the lot. That's why. Okay, I thought I got everybody on the lot. All right, let's get her, and then we will be done. And intermediate. Let's see, absolute age. Zero. Yeah, I wish that EA would actually do this to where you wouldn't have to worry about that, and you could just start them all off on day one or day zero, whatever it is. Would make a big difference. All right, so you can see that there's big changes since we did the asylum. They're actually now using those phones, which is kind of cool. Yeah, these clothing outfits, they're going to change completely from what I originally had, so you're going to have to get used to it just like I am. I have no idea what half of them are wearing all the time, so it'll be interesting to see what they do. Okay, as far as meeting people, we know everybody in the house, and we have a little bit of a relationship with them. And we got Andrew and Audra. I think she's probably the school mascot. Let's see, I don't know these people. Don't know those people. Jeannie's already on her third outfit. No, that's her second outfit of the day. No, that's her third outfit, isn't it? Because I didn't put her in that. That's her that's her formal wear, I think. So yeah, you can see I went a little bit extreme for her. I had to. And of course, I love this. I don't get to use this outfit very much at all in my game. So when I actually was thinking of this challenge, I thought, this is perfect. I can use that, all that kind of stuff here where I wouldn't normally use it. All right, I have no idea what you're reading, buddy. Taking the ball home. Okay, well, that's not going to help. And you're actually working on a skill. I love it because you're doing that. I don't count that as one of the skill building items that you can use because that's something that everybody has regardless. So it does not count against your five. As you can see, nobody's gravitating towards the casino or the slot machine, which I was kind of surprised. I figured they would actually go ahead and do that now, but apparently not. So that's all right. And of course, she's over there. I'm just going to click over so I can get closer to her. As long as they keep them fed, they're not going to cause any danger. But once work and everything gets going, they're going to forget, and it's going to turn nasty on us in a heartbeat. So just be ready. All right, Nicholas, you're being real exciting reading your book, and the rest of them are just kind of being that exciting, too. At least he's going to do something. So, Jefferson, you're going to actually learn some of the guitar. At midnight, I can go in and take anything out. So if by any chance he's got the guitar still in his inventory, at midnight I can take it out and put it back in there for everybody else to use, which is fine with me. I'm so glad we don't have to do sculpting and inventing and all that mess, so it should be kind of fun for us. We don't have to spend too much time doing the skills that... that he needs. It's just basically logic, and he can do that in a whole different amount of ways. And there's my timer. Alright guys, I'm going to go ahead and end it here. When we come back, we'll just pick right back up with the rest of this evening and see how their first night goes here in the asylum. Hope you guys are enjoying it, and thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time.